on the phone with us, one of the best trainers in the history of boxing, Robert Garcia. Robert, I wanted to get your take to the big shock this weekend, George Kambosos. Nobody thought he's going to even be in the fight long enough to last, getting the win over TEOFIMO in New York.
It was unbelievable fight. Both went in there to put up a great, great fight. But yes, Kambosos was just one of those guys that nobody expected him to win. You know, personally, myself, I thought it would go a few rounds, but I thought TEOFIMO would knock him out. I don't know. It was one of those fights where I'm sure this guy trained like never before. He worked his ass off. Had one thing in mind only, was to win, and he went out there and pulled it off. Man, it was one of those fights where you can't be mad at neither of them. You know, they both fought a great fight, but Kambosos obviously took the win and showed the boxing world, and not only the boxing world, but the whole world, that when you want to do something and you put yourself into it, everything's possible.
Now, that said, everybody, since the fight, everybody's been calling out Kambosos. When TEOFIMO was the champ, nobody was calling him out. What you as a trainer, what do everybody see in Kambosos that they think they're going to fight him and beat him right away?
Well, I think, you know, see, TEOFIMO looked sensational when he became champion against
Richard Comey, the guy fighting Lomachenko. Richard Comey.
Yeah, looked sensational, knocked him out.
Ugly.
And,
yeah.
Well, you know, like, what was it, first or second round? So made himself look right away like a superstar. Then goes and beats Lomachenko, pound for pound, the best fighter in the world. Goes and beats him. So everybody was putting TEOFIMO as probably the best lightweight out there. Everybody was seeing TEOFIMO as he could beat any of those guys. But you know, never thought Kambosos even had a chance. So now that Kambosos beat TEOFIMO, you know, I think it was because TEOFIMO just fought the wrong fight. He you know, his mind was only by knockout, first round knockout, and he goes out and swinging hard punches, trying to knock him out with one punch. And throughout the fight, I think the dad was pushing him for finish him, like pushing him for the knockout. So I think they fought the wrong fight. They made mistakes. TEOFIMO made a lot of mistakes in the fight, and Kambosos took advantage of it and pulled off the win. Not because Kambosos is better. I think it was just that TEOFIMO fought the wrong fight. He was looking for one punch. Kambosos took advantage of it and pulled it off. I think that's what everybody else sees. You know, everybody else sees that. I probably agree. I think Devin Haney, I think even Ryan Garcia, Tank, Loma, I think all those guys could beat Kambosos.
Rowley said the same thing yesterday, and everybody got mad at Rowley. But obviously, Rowley is a boxer. You're a former champion. You have made 13 champions. You obviously know the sport. You're not hating. You're just stating your opinion.
No, I'm not hating. I'm very happy for Kambosos. He fucking, you know, TEOFIMO was saying, you know, people are saying that maybe the layoff affected him. Maybe all those dates changing so many, I think like 8 times, you know, the dates would change, and they're training and you're having personal problems. Well, so was Kambosos. Kambosos was in the same situation. So it's not like TEOFIMO was the only one waiting for those dates and getting cancellations and anything. Kambosos was having the same problems. So that cannot be an excuse. Or he had personal problems, or, you know, him and his wife were maybe splitting up. Well, everybody has personal problems. When you're a fighter, you know, you're in a team, you're in a soccer team, you're in a football team, you're in a basketball team. If you don't have a good day, they could pull you out of the game and put somebody else, and nothing happens. You'll be ready for next game. But not in boxing. In boxing, you have to be different than anybody else. You have to be an athlete that's different. You have to have that mentality that if you have personal problems, you have to put that shit aside and compete and fight the way, you know, you're in a fucking fight. You're risking your life. You want to injure your opponent. You want to you know, knock out your opponent. That's the mentality you have to have. You can't let problems affect you in a fight. In any other sport, they'll pull you out of the game and bring somebody else in, but not in boxing. Yeah. In boxing, you're the one that has to go in there and fight. So, you know, you can't put those excuses there. Because he waited too long. Because the day changed so many times. No, Kambosos went through the same thing. So that's not an excuse. I think Kambosos had the biggest win of his career, the biggest win of Australia. So he's going to enjoy it. He's going to maybe have a couple defenses before he fights anybody big. But I don't think he's the best lightweight out there by beating TEOFIMO.
Not only I love
his promoter. I love Lou De Bella. I have a great relationship with Peter.
Peter Kahn, the manager. He showed me a picture of you and him when he's like 18, 19 years old.
Yes. No, I'm telling you, I've known him for many, many years. I know his trainer that trains Sayas also.
Yep. Cuban guy from Miami.
Yes, great win for them. But it was just that perfect night for Kambosos to shine, to look good, and have such an impressive win against the one that everybody thought was the best lightweight in the division. It was a great win, but that doesn't put him as the best lightweight, at least not to me. I think he earned his spot to make $2-5 million on a fight against Ryan, on a fight against Devin Haney. Maybe he put himself in that position, and that's great for him. Good for him. Good for his family. You know, he's never made that kind of money. You know, TEOFIMO was out for so long, but he made 1.2 in his last fight against Lomachenko.
Yeah.
Kambosos didn't make that kind of money in his last fight. I'd probably say he didn't even make close to 100,000.
Probably right. Yeah.
So he probably had the same problems when it comes to money. Maybe even worse problems, because he didn't make that kind of money that TEOFIMO made. So you know, so if you compare, you know, the layoffs and you know the change in your dates, they all went through the same. They both went through the same thing. So you can't put those excuses. He just had a perfect night. He fought a great fight. He won that decision. When TEOFIMO was the one that made those mistakes. I think TEOFIMO went out there looking for the knockout. He promised the first round knockout, and he wanted to deliver, and he made a lot of mistakes. Then throughout the fight, he was still looking for the knockout. He almost had it, but it wasn't enough, you know, and Kambosos had a great night and pulled off the win, and I'm happy for him. And now he's going to go enjoy a couple title defenses, maybe in his hometown, and then come and fight one of those big names for, you know, like I said, I don't know how much, $2-5 million, whatever it is. Fucking, you know, he did something that nobody ever expected from him. So good for him.
So he talked about fighting Haney in February, but if both he and Haney are talking about a fight, you have Jojo Diaz in just a couple of days. You should never talk about your next fight when you have an opponent in front of you.
Yeah, you know, look, Haney still has a very dangerous fight in front of him against Jojo Diaz, so he shouldn't talk ahead. But I don't even think it's good to say, you know, even for Kambosos, you know, he was just in a tough fucking fight. Even though he won, he still got dropped. He was hurt. He took a beating also in the fight. So he needs at least a month to heal.
Yep.
And that's really that'll be end of December. So how can he fight in February? There's no way he's gonna fight in February. You know, I think TEOFIMO's dad was also saying that TEOFIMO's gonna fight in February. His cut's not gonna be ready in February.
Yeah, no, that was a bad cut.
That cut's not gonna heal. And it's gonna heal and barely in a couple of months. Then you still need another 2 or 3 months to prepare. So TEOFIMO won't fight probably till May or June of next year.
And then another thing I wanted to bring up. So in boxing in general, and this is one thing I don't like about this sport, Robert. Joshua loses to Usyk. Joshua got exposed. Lomachenko loses to TEOFIMO. Lomachenko got exposed. TEOFIMO loses to Kambosos. All these guys are champions. All these guys are crazy talented. They're the best of the best. Losing is part of life. You don't have to like kick them when they're down. Like he got exposed. Listen, it's boxing.
But that's the boxing world, you know. you lose one fight and everybody's already talking about you and saying that you got exposed and that you're no good and this and that. But, you know, you lose in every, you know, in life itself, you know, so many things, you know. Sometimes you lose a job, you lose, you know, you get divorced, you need help, you know, you don't have a job, you know, all that is, those are losses. But if you're strong enough, you come back from those losses. And how many times have we seen a fighter lose, but then come back, and then again he becomes a hero? You know, it's just the way this boxing world is, that with one loss, people already talk shit, and it's mostly people that probably never even laced gloves up. So, you know, you just got to ignore all that. You know, TEOFIMO will come back strong. Joshua will come back strong. Lomachenko has already, you know, shown that he's still a very talented fighter, even though he's already lost two times. He's still one of the best fighters pound for pound in the world. And I know TEOFIMO will come back. You know, they just need to learn from their mistakes. Everybody learns from, and sometimes somebody needs, a lot of times you need a loss to learn, you know. Sometimes you need to lose in life, you know. You need to go to zero to come back strong and be stronger. So I think TEOFIMO will come back stronger and become champion again.
And that brings me to another thing. So TEOFIMO and his dad are 1-2 combo. They won undisputed in 16 fights. They lose one fight, and everybody says, you need to get rid of your dad, you need to get rid of that. They told Canelo to get rid of Eddie Reynoso, and look at them. So it's not necessarily the coach right away that's at fault.
Yeah, well, I think there does have to be changes, and it doesn't have to be with getting rid of the dad. But the dad does need to learn to make a few changes, and not in training, because you look what he did with his son, from the amateurs to the Olympics to the pros, and to become undisputed champion, you know, that's big. Who can say you know they made their fighter undisputed? Very few.
In 16 fights, unheard of.
Yes, very, very. There's nobody that could say that, you know. So they've done, you know, he's done a great job. But also with all the fame, the popularity, it does catch up to some people, and the dad needs to go back to basics, go back to old school, and when they were nobodies, when they had nothing yet, all the hunger that they had, you know, that needs to change also, and that doesn't mean he needs any trainer, but they do need to change their ways of being, their ways of acting, the way they train. Now maybe things have changed, you know, in training camps. I don't know, but there's some changes that might need to be done. But you know, if the dad made them since day one to become undisputed champion for one fight, you don't need, you know, that doesn't mean you need to change a trainer. Maybe you need to go back to the way you were before.
Yeah, that's true. So one more thing, Robert. I want to know what's next for you. You have two fights this weekend in the same night in two different locations. I want you to tell people what's going on.
Yes, we have Alexis Espino fighting on the Devin Haney, Jojo Diaz card. That's in Vegas, and Pita will be going to that one. I have three other guys fighting in Stockton, California, where I'm going to be. I'm going to be in Stockton this Saturday with Gabriel Murataya, Felix Soria, and Cardenas, Arturo Cardenas, all three fighting in Stockton. So hopefully we see a lot of RGBA fans in Stockton, because I have three fights there. And I'm working on our other fight. We have Antonio Mireles fighting in Iowa this Saturday also. So for that one, I might send Chepe to that one. So, you know, our super heavyweight.
Yeah,
so
he's a great kid. Great person.
We've been talking to him and his manager about maybe who's going to fly. So maybe Chepe is going to fly to that one. We still haven't decided yet. But yeah, those are the fights that we have this weekend. But yeah, people in Vegas, obviously, you know, they're going to be at the big fight, the Devin Haney. But people in Northern California, Stockton, I'll see you guys there, man. You know, I know it's going to be a big crowd, and I'll be there with three of my fighters, and I'll be there to meet, take pictures, whatever it takes, you know, to get people there, you know, and, you know, hopefully we meet a lot of people in Stockton. Never been to Stockton, so I'm actually looking forward to it.
It's the 209, the home of Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz, of course. So everybody, right. Do you know the venue or the details? Where can they go? It's Toscano Boxing.
Yes, Toscano Boxing. Obviously, it's on my social media. You know the event.
At Garcia Boxing.
Yeah, at Garcia Boxing. So I'm sure looking for. Yeah, but it's going to be a great event. I know Toscano Boxing Promotions has done great events, and you know, teaming up with ERGBA, and we should have a good event. You know, I know my fighters are ready. They're going to go out there and perform, and hopefully the crowd is there to support all the local fighters also, because there's a lot of local talent on that show. And you know, I'll be there. You know, I'll be more than happy to take pictures, sign autographs, whatever it takes. You know, I'm gonna be there, spend time with our Stockton people.
Absolutely. It's a great place. It's always on the news, but this is something positive for change. So it's a good thing. So there you have it, Robert. Thank you so much. Any message for TEOFIMO Lopez in this video?
Nah, look, he's a strong kid already. The way they were raised, the way they grew up, I'm sure it wasn't easy for them. So they're already strong mentally people. They'll come back from there. You know, if they came from zero to go to the Olympics, to become an undisputed champion of the world from zero, you know, a loss shouldn't keep them there. You know, they need to come back, and I know they will, because they're very strong mentally, and I know them personally. The kid is not a kid that's going to give up. He's going to come back stronger than ever. So I expect great things from him. I know he's a great talented fighter, and a lot of mistakes were made. They just need to correct them. They need to learn and accept them. They also need to accept that there were mistakes being done, both him and the dad. But once they do that, they'll come back in even stronger, because they've already come from zero to become an undisputed champion of the world. So why can't he make that happen again? I think he's got all the tools and the talent to do it.
Absolutely. That's, you know, there's an old saying, that's where you have erasers and pencils. So, you know, right, you could fix it. But Robert Garcia, everybody, make sure to follow him at Garcia Boxing. And again, this weekend, he has 3 fights in Stockton, Toscano Boxing. Look him up or go to Garcia Boxing. And he has also Espino, future champion, fighting on the JoJo Diaz-Devin Haney card. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.